Saturday will be a big day in Baltimore City as President-elect Obama will stop here via train on his way to D.C. for Inauguration Day. Obama will speak in front of the War Memorial Building Saturday afternoon, and preps are definitely underway. 11 News reporter Lowell Meltzer now joins us live at the War Memorial. He has the very latest for us. Lowell?
Yeah, production crews just put the finishing touches on the staging area behind me here. Tomorrow they'll begin the tough task of putting in all of the electronics for this event. And while there is a lot of pomp and circumstance surrounding President-elect Obama's visit here to Baltimore City, there are also a lot of questions like who's going to pay for it and will the mayor make a speech? It's a cold job, but somebody's got to do it. Baltimore Union production crews assemble the stage that President-elect Obama will use to address a capacity crowd down at the War Memorial Saturday. And yes, the weather has been a problem.
The wind concerns me, what it's going to be like tomorrow. That could make it problems. It's mostly weather-related. As far as sizing here, it's not overwhelming in any sense.
As you can imagine, the city will be using all of its manpower to make sure that things go smoothly. And Mayor Sheila Dixon says the federal government will pick up the bill.
From DPW, transportation, police, fire, health, et cetera. And so we will be applying for federal reimbursement.
And speaking of the mayor and the controversy surrounding her, she gave a political answer as far as if she would speak at the event.
We haven't gotten the details of the program yet, but I'm just really pleased to be able to contribute and be a part of the whole effort.
Now, if you are thinking of coming to see the festivities, they will start letting people in at 1 p.m. on Saturday at the intersection of Baltimore Street and Guilford Avenue. If you can't get in, don't worry. An overflow watching area will be available near the amphitheater and harbor areas. There are a number of road closures you also need to be familiar with. Beginning at 4 a.m., I-83 will be closed from President Street to North Avenue in both directions. Orleans Street from Gay Street to St. Paul will be closed from 2 p.m. to 9 p.m. So as you can imagine, everyone is being urged to use public transportation. As far as parking is concerned, you are encouraged to park at M&T Bank Stadium or park in a garage outside of the downtown area. And just a couple of things. One thing we're noticing right now with the closure of the 100 block of North Gay Street, traffic is a nightmare around City Hall. So you're going to want to avoid this area tonight and tomorrow night and probably through the end of the event, if at all possible. Also, a couple things to know. More than 100,000 people are expected here through the event. So you're going to want to arrive early and make sure that you dress appropriately because it is supposed to be freezing out here. That means gloves, hats, scarves, thermal underwear, anything to endure the cold weather for a number of hours. And of course, you can get the latest information on our website, WBALTV.com. For now, we're live in front of the War Memorial. I'm Lowell Meltzer, WBAL TV 11 News.